Hello, everybody.
Hello, everyone. It's me and this guy.
Got a bracket there because that's our hotkey to start our recording. Game. Pete, have you heard of this game before?
I've seen it, but I have no idea what it is.
Right then, this is Game Dev Tycoon.
It's something like The Sims.
Not really. It's not really like The Sims.
God, well,
but basically, it's a game where you sort of make your own games.
A game where
so
you, make
you build
game?
Your own video game empire type
right,
thing.
Okay.
And, well, if you want to say that it's a simulator, I suppose you could say it's a simulator of what we're supposed to do at college.
So, oh yeah.
Because we're supposed to make games, but most of the day we just play them instead. So
yeah, most, yeah.
Yeah. Unfortunately. Yeah, so do I. But, yeah, this is a very good game. It's, I'd say, quite realistic.
Okay.
So, yeah, let's get playing. So, what do we want to call the company? Cinity Studios.
Cinity Pictures or Cinity Studios?
Cinity Game Studio. Nah, let's just call it Cinity Studios.
Okay.
Cinity Studios and then the player.
The player.
We can only have one player, so.
Okay.
What colour hair?
Let's go for. Nah, that guy. Oh.
That guy?
Yeah.
Right, okay. And colour shirt?
I'll let you choose the shirt.
Alright, let me pick. I'm going to go that one.
That one?
Actually, that kind of looks like our old college lecturer.
Oh.
Hmm.
I kind of know what you mean.
Let's go the one that's left. So, the player name.
Sanjay.
No, we're not going to call him that. Because that was our old college lecturer's name, he's now left.
Bob. Heinrich. Adolf.
No.
Okay.
Oh god, this is choosing stuff is the hardest thing, isn't
Henderson.
It?
Henderson. Henderson's vehicles. Do you remember? Isa.
Winston. Wait, Winston.
Winston Stimson.
Or
Isa. Shy Isa.
Isa. Tam. Tam.
I agree, right, let's do it.
We have Tam.
Okay, Tam.
Tam from Still Game. unlock hint. Since you've played the game before, you can choose. Would you like to import the previous. Yes, please.
Okay.
So that way we don't have to have the tutorials.
Oh my
come
god,
up.
This looks.
Basically, this is your garage.
Right.
You've got a car that's pretty much out of action in there. A pong board that's got a score up there. You also have a door.
Who's watching our friend like game of the week? On the
yeah, he is. It looks like he is. Although,
oh.
I don't remember getting that high in it.
Oh, yeah.
So, well, score high.
If we were playing
whatever.
That's a short ladder.
Yeah, so he's got a very short ladder. Some holes, whatever they're for. A shelves with books. A box. A bin with lots of stuff in. Nice mat. Some spanners, a tyre, his car, and a blanket that
and
he wrapped his car up with.
And a computer on your fan as well.
Yes, and a lamp, and a notepad. So basically, what you do is, this is a purely mouse and click-based game.
Okay.
So what you do is, you just left-click, and it brings up like this menu here. So at the moment, we only have the option to develop a new game. So we have to... Right, I don't know what the hell that is, but... Still, we
game.
Can just pick a topic. I normally choose to do the name last. So you get a few at the start. So you get... it's completely random which ones you get. But I
dungeon.
Believe you get four. So you get we've got dungeon, UFO, hacking, and superheroes.
Okay.
So if you play this game, you'll get probably loads of different ones. But, yeah. How come I've only got 46k? You should have 70. Okay, no bother about that, but, and what one should we go for, Pete?
What, so we pick a topic for the game?
Yeah.
So, dungeon, identify...
I'm superheroes.
Superheroes, yeah, we can.
We could have superheroes...
Action.
Action. Pick a platform. We'll do it for the PC because it's a bit cheaper.
Okay.
And let's call it...
Dark Knight Rises again.
No, they're not going for anything like that. Mm. How about,
Squid school.
A super squid. Kind of a reference from Minecraft Resource Spotlight.
Super Squid.
Super Squid.
Super Squid.
What?
Let's go.
Super Squid. Okay, so we'll have a graphics-based one because obviously nobody will play it. It's text-based and it's action, and it's called Super Squid. Here we go. Already got two bugs before we pretty much even started.
Development runs for three stages.
So, this should really have, unless I clicked the wrong button, this should have turned off. But so you can choose how much you want to spend on each one. So if you want to put all your effort into gameplay, you can do that. Or if you want to spend all your time in stories and quests, then you can do that. We don't have an engine at the moment, so I'm thinking just lower that one quite a bit.
Okay.
And put gameplay up. And stories and quests, because we want it to be a story-based
story-based game.
So, games development has now started. Apparently I have something in my Steam inventory now, whatever that is. So, you can generate points, which you'll get at the top. So...
Okay.
The only one you really need to worry about at the moment is the bugs, because they're a bit of a problem.
Bugs, okay.
Obviously, later on in the game, you want your design and technology ones to be as high as possible.
Yeah.
And your research ones build up because you can spend those on researching stuff. So, yes. Right, now, we've got to have... All of these have pretty much got to be good, haven't they, for a superhero game.
AI level, absolutely.
So I'm thinking artificial intelligence has got to be good because you've got to have some people to beat up, haven't you? This is the first year. I don't know what year this is. So at the moment we only have PC and G64, so it's quite early on. So level design doesn't, I'm going to say, doesn't really need to be that high.
Put it a tinty though, but not too high.
Dialogue, I'm tempted to just leave it where it is.
Yeah,
and then click OK.
Yeah, that will do.
So let's just wait for him to develop the game.
Ooh.
There might be another screen that's going to come up in a minute.
Oh, it's still developing. Oh, I see.
Yeah, there are. So let's see. Sorry, I should let some of you read these, but I'm pretty much explaining everything. So you can choose here some of your features. So you can have 2D graphics version 1. You can research more things later on, and basic sounds.
Okay.
So yeah, and you've got to have. This is, sorry, I started a sentence off there because never finished it. And sorry, just ignore that. I'm losing the plot. I'm trying to say things too quickly and not thinking about it. So this is sort of the graphics and sound design element of it. So you just choose these to, move these to select how you want to prioritise each one. So we've got to make the world look good, haven't we?
Yeah.
And I'd say sounds have also got to be good. Graphics don't need to be brilliant because it is quite an old game.
Some of the story's alright, I think.
We currently have 18,000.
Is that good?
No, not really. So, development is now complete, and then what we'll do is we will wait for bugs to be removed because we're not actually in the 21st century yet, so updates don't exist.
So where are we in the world timeline?
I have no idea actually what year we're in.
It won't be the medieval period.
Medievals didn't have cars or computers. They probably didn't have houses.
Yeah, but that car looks so terrible. It looks as though.
Did medievals have houses? I guess they did.
Medieval. Yeah.
So this is Super Squid. So this is basically the final screen for your game. So this shows you all the stuff that you've put into it and how much effort. So Tam is level is level 1 at the moment. So here you see how much design has gone into it and how much technology has gone into it. I'm not quite sure what the numbers correspond to, but here you have the option to either bin the game or release it. Obviously, we're going to release it because we need the money, and the money is quickly going out the window because, we're spending lots on developing it and rent and stuff. So now the reviews. This is everybody's dreaded bit.
Okay.
The game reviews.
So what's a good score to have on?
10.
Unsurprising.
I remember once Hayden made, I think it was three really good games at once. He had three. He had some that got all 10s, and then after that, the game after that got 2s, and he was absolutely gutted because he lost so many fans. So, I mean, this isn't too bad for the first game. Screw you, Star Games, but everybody else, that's not too bad.
5, 6,
and after publishing the game, yeah, you can analyze it and create reports and stuff. So, yeah, you'll have, whenever it comes up. So, Cinity Studios, a newcomer in the games industry, have just released their first game, Super Squid. The game is moderate response from the reviewers. We're curious whether Cinity Studios would deliver in the future.
Ooh.
So, in the moment, you'll have all of these bar chart things come up on the side of the screen, and we've just lost quite a bit of money because of expenses. We've made it into the charts at number 67.
That's wow.
Although the thing is, though, back then there wasn't so much competition, so.
So it's not.
I don't know. And the. I wanted these to go.
We now have six fans, apparently.
Yeah, which is currently less than our subscribers, so. Yeah. But basically, you sell so many units every week, and you get the money for it. And the game's on sale until it's no longer a success. So, pretty much, 8k monthly cost. That's quite a lot for the start, but, oh well, that's nothing that we can do.
31.5.
But anyway, we need to get developing a new game, because otherwise,
we'll die.
We aren't going to have any money left. So,
Hacking? Yes.
Which one?
Strategy, that sounds like
strategy.
Hacking.
Platform, as much as I want to make it on there, I don't know, because that's got higher market share at the moment.
57.5.
I don't want to go bust on the second game though. I mean, that's got quite a lot of market share still, but that's got the advantage.
That's got an advantage and it's on the better.
Should we see how much it's going to cost?
Yeah, okay, still make it entertaining.
Well, we'll still have sales from the other. Oh, wait, hang on, no, don't call it game two. Right, what are we going to call it?
Panda versus keyboard.
It has to sort of be relevant to the genre.
Oh, okay. Because
otherwise the reviewers won't like it. And we don't really want to lose money.
It's a hacking game.
I don't know.
Hacking.
I know Watch Dogs is one, but...
Rob and Chop.
What?
Rob and Chop. Don't put that, actually.
What about Spy?
Spy?
Or E-Spy?
I-Spy.
I-Spy. Yeah, I-Spy. There we go. That'll do. So, we want to have 2D graphics, start development.
I-Spy?
So, we currently don't have a lot of money, but the game's still selling quite well. So...
Getting paid, that needs to be high.
Obviously, at the moment, we don't have an engine, so... We'll just keep them.
It's bad if you're a car, but not so bad if you're...
Okay, we are now in debt, $2.5 grand. But hopefully... Hopefully, Super Squid will keep selling.
Super Squid.
Right, we want to try and make this really good, so... AI... Just leave it about there. I'd say just leave it about
it's
there.
It's hacking, it's not...
Oh no, it's off the market, great.
Oh no.
So, we've got to sell this. We have got to sell this on Ninvento, which they...
Because
they haven't been able to obtain the copyrights or usage rights to use the actual company names. They're kind of mixing them up.
Ninvento.
So, yeah, Ninvento is Nintendo, because they made one of the first systems. Yeah, they get featured in the game first. So, let's have a look. Graphics, I want to try and make this a high graphic game. Sound, I don't know, world design. Try and focus on graphics, I would say, for this one.
Okay. Warning.
Oh no.
God, mine's 14k, Jesus.
If it gets below 50k, we'll go bankrupt.
What?
Jesus. Come on, we've got to get this game fixed and get it out. I do not want to go bust just yet. Get that bug out. And it's just put another bug in. Good job I didn't click finish. Finish. Right. There we go. We gotta get this game out and fast.
New record.
New record. Yeah, we've got new records.
Tam.
There. Tam's level is going up. So Tam will be very pleased with himself.
Tam.
Okay. Let's get the game out. Let's get the reviewers going. Sick. And here's the game reviews. Ooh, I saw 10 flash up then.
Oh, deep.
Good rhyme.
Six, is that alright?
Six is alright. Five's alright. Oh. Come on, give us a 10.
No!
Current stages, that's alright. I like it, yeah, so do I. because we made it.
We never played
it. Come on, gotta get this. Gotta sell lots. That's our financial crisis over. We've got cash, not a lot, but we've got cash.
300 of what? Oh my god.
Ninvento has confirmed recent rumours. Yeah, so that's the Ninvento Tez. So I don't know what Tez stands for, but.
Tez?
Yeah. It was the NES, so the Nintendo Entertainment System.
Oh, that's probably.
But since it's Ninvento and not Tintendo or something.
It should be called any.
I can't really see how they've called it Tez.
Tez?
But, yeah, I haven't actually seen what the Xbox 360 and that's called. But anyway, we need to get another game out.
Okay.
So, pick another
topic.
Actually, hang on a minute. I'm thinking, let's do a bit of research.
Okay.
We could research some new topics. So, you can research loads of stuff. So, you can make a new engine, which we currently haven't got enough research points for. Those are your research points up there in the blue circle where my mouse is. You should be able to see the mouse because I've turned it on. So, yeah. And you could choose to research a new topic.
Zombies!
Okay, we're definitely going for zombies then.
Please.
So if you click start research, Tam or your chosen person will start to research the game. And you can then make games on that topic. So, research complete. So there we go. Should we make a new zombie game?
Oh, yes, please.
Right, Pete's going to be very happy. So we've got to have action, haven't we?
Yes.
Pick platform, go for G64 because it's the best. And
just keep the free there and write something for it.
The undead.
The untoten, as it said in German.
We German though.
Huh? Well, no, not really.
We'll just call it the undead for now.
If we want Nazi zombies then.
Okay, that's going to cost us quite a bit at the moment. But you have to invest.
Oh, minus 10k.
You have to invest in stuff.
Oh, minus.
Right, so.
Gameplay.
Stories and quests?
Stories and quests. Well, it
depends. Do you want that high? Because if you're thinking of like Call of Duty zombies,
yeah.
I know at the moment we haven't really got enough research stuff, but
so lower that a bit. Then.
Lower that a bit and put gameplay.
Oh,
up.
Yeah, put gameplay to the max.
So yeah, just to let you know as well, this is only going to be like a 2 or 3 part of Let's Play. I'm just saying it's not going to be like The Sims 3 where it's every week.
Oh, okay.
So, unfortunately, I Spy is now off the market. But it sold 9,108 units, generating $63,784 or pounds in sales.
It's not being Lord Sugar's boardroom.
Yes, except Tam is Lord Sugar, and he's doing all the work.
We found a bug, apparently.
Yes.
Artificial intelligence.
Dialogue's not too much. And actually, we might as well just bump dialogue pretty much. Level design. So I reckon that'll do.
Yeah, that's right. There we go. Oh, we're getting hardly any bugs. Look at that. Excellent.
Yes, good old zombies.
No!
Spoke a bit too soon there. So, world design. Yeah, we've got to have that nice.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, we've got to have all of them nice, but the thing is that you can't...
what's the minus?
I'm not quite sure what that is. So, I'm just going to leave that. Now, graphic level. And sound isn't that important.
But it's about halfway, roughly.
About there?
Yeah, that'll do.
Is that alright?
Mm-hmm.
The Undead. I quite like that name, actually.
The Undead.
Right, just get this game out because, we're struggling for money.
Oh.
So we're struggling for money at the minute.
Oh, no. Minus 25.6k.
Oh, the Tez has been released.
That's lovely.
The thing that I don't particularly like about this game is you have to wait until the system has been released before you can develop games for it.
Yeah.
Whereas if you, like in real life, if you want to get the edge... Big developers start developing for systems that haven't yet been released yet. So, like, the Xbox One, Turn 10, we're making Forza 5 for that.
Well, it didn't do a very good job.
Because if they released, like, the Tez and there were no games coming out of it for its launch, you wouldn't do very well, would you?
You'd probably have a console and nothing.
They just bring a console, there's no games.
Right, this is our console, and, yeah, buy it for no reason. Don't.
No! Informed gamer, you sadden me.
Meh. Phil's favourite expression.
Meh. You really do annoy me.
Okay, so I spoke to this morning.
Star Games, I forgive you. Phil?
Yes.
Star Games, I forgive you for what I said about you earlier. Right, hopefully this will sell a bit better.
Untoted.
Anyway, let's get a new game out. We could...
Pick a topic? Any topic?
I know what we could do. UFO. Action... Go PC this time. Space Destroyer. Space Destroyer? Space Invaders.
Space Invaders, Space Destroyer.
So, something like that.
Start the villain. There we go. Let's go. Contract. I finished. The end of it.
Ooh, contracting business. Ah, so this is contract work. So what you could do is, if you're ever short on money, and you think that you're going to be able to fulfil a contract, you can do work for, you could do work for other people. So you could do, like, I don't know, software design, or like design a spreadsheet for a company if they need one. Okay. So you could do various things to earn a little bit of cash if you're struggling.
Look at this.
Right, we've got to have AI very high, if you'll pardon the rhyme, rather than pardon the pun.
There's no rhyme there.
Yeah, there was. So,
oh yeah, there was actually. Yeah, but if it was emergency.
Oh, look, the undead has achieved a company sales record. Wow! 10k units.
Milestone.
Peter, you should be happy, Pete. The zombie game has sold lots.
Yay.
Right, I'm going to try and make this a bit like Space Invaders, so...
Old design.
It's just a blooming back... It's just black background,
isn't
it? It's
just a space background.
Yeah.
Which
so
is
at least we're actually making money at the moment, which is good.
Well, Doug, look at... Oh, yeah, Bug's getting...
And the undead is still selling.
Excellent job.
So, let's put Space Destroyer out. I remember once I made a game, I think it was called something like Captain Hook's Adventure. Yeah. Peter Pan. but I made a game, it was like on the portable console. I sold over 1 million units.
Whoa.
I was just like, whoa.
Captain Hook.
The undead is now off the market.
Oh.
But as soon as we've done a bit more research, we can get an engine going, and as soon as we've earned a bit more money, we can get an engine going.
Oh my god, how are we going to play this ball?
I don't know. I want to try and do it for a farewell. Uninspiring. Okay, debt at Star Games, I hate you again. Fun at stages. Is there any reviewers that haven't let us down yet? UFO and Action is a great combination.
I hate Star Games, it's the worst company. I like it.
4, 5, 5, 6. Yeah, thank you, All Games.
Yeah, All Games, they're good at it.
Right, let's get this game out. And there we go, that's selling. All right. It's not doing too badly.
Keep going.
Right, okay, now we have enough to research an engine. So we can research an engine.
Research an engine.
So we'll research the engine first. Oh. And then we can actually make one to make our games with.
Yeah,
so,
okay.
Yep, this is going to take, I think, a few minutes.
God, Chad's been sat there for ages.
I know. Imagine he was just sat there for like the rest of his life, just never, ever planning on getting up,
no,
sitting there writing video games.
He's always drinking his piss and eating his toenails.
Right, so we can now create a custom game engine. So if you go here, do an engine. So let's call the engine, like, I don't know. Zinity engine.
Zinity engine. Thomas the Tank Engine.
Actually, no. I'm gonna save Zinity for later.
Thomas the Tank
Engine.
Call
it Cinity engine. That's how you spell engine, isn't it? Yeah. So you can spend money on putting different things into your engine. At the moment, I want to try and put save games in, and probably that one.
2D graphics.
So that's gonna cost us 60 grand.
We got a fair bit of dosh.
Linear story. I think I'll leave that one out for now. So, yeah, we'll leave that for now. We still got a fair bit of money. Space Destroyer is still selling at the moment. I can't imagine it's going to be selling for longer. No, it's not now.
Oh.
But still, that sold all right. We made a fair bit of money from it. It sold, I can't remember how much now. I closed it, sorry. Right, and then we can make a game on the new Cinity engine.
Cool. A lovely research point.
Cinity engine is now complete. So now we can make a game on the Cinity engine.
Okay.
Actually, first of all, I think I might do some contract work if we can. Just,
okay.
Just A, show you what it is, and B, so we can earn a bit of more cash. So what you can do is, you can install Microsoft BOSS on computers. I guess that's supposed to be Microsoft BIOS. Mm. But yeah, so here we go. Sprite sheet software, whatever the hell that is.
It's a sheet of paper.
And yeah, I think I'm going to go with the first one. Now, You get 21k if you successfully complete it. This is how long you have to do it, and this is what effort you have to put into it. And that's the penalty if you don't fulfill it. So I'm going to accept this, hoping that we can do it. So come on, Tam. Come on, Tam. You have so much money at stake here. It's unbelievable. Come on. Oh, my God. I don't think he's going to make it, is he? Oh, this is good. Close. Yes, we did it. So we got 21k now to play with.
It's Jason again.
Yeah, we go.
Jason Bourne's contacted us. Let's see what he's got to say.
Excellent work. You have new contracts every 6 months. What? Six months?
That's ages. That's almost half a year.
All right, let's develop a new game. So, pick a topic.
What haven't we done
yet? We haven't gone dungeon.
Dungeon, yeah.
We could go do a dungeon RPG. Pick a platform. PC?
PC, okay. Welcome to the madhouse.
Game engine, the Cinity engine.
Welcome to the madhouse.
What are we going to call it?
Welcome to the madhouse.
Welcome to the madhouse.
Yeah. Dungeon. Asylum.
Asylum?
Asylum.
We could call it asylum.
I don't know. I'm trying to think of everything associated with the word dungeon. Prison bars, guards, dungeons.
Bars? We could have bars? I don't know.
Rotting bars. Decay.
It's an RPG,
filth,
though.
Old. Prison guards, asylum, remote, deserted.
Dungeon.
Yeah, okay.
How's that? Let's do that, I don't know.
Simplistic.
2D graphics, yeah, why not?
2D?
2D version 2 graphics. So that's put us kind of in debt, but...
So we're like heavy on dungeon then?
Yeah. So let's put a lot of effort into the engine this time. And story some quests as well, gameplay as well. So
there we go.
Yeah, that should do. So you want to try and put as much effort into the engine as well, because that way you can put effort into the things that come with the engine. So like the save game feature or the 2D graphics, you can put effort into that. So let's wait and see what happens here.
Ooh.
Dialogues. Don't really need dialogues if it's... I'm thinking something like RuneScape. We don't really need dialogues for that. Okay. But level design and AI, we need those fairly high. AI, we need it fairly high.
Awful intelligence.
This is a good rhyme. I like making
rhymes.
I quite like making rhymes.
Why didn't you go and be a poetry teacher?
World design, sound and graphics. There we go.
So one thing I didn't understand in English, why we had to study poetry.
I don't know. I don't really know why we had to study Shakespeare, to be honest.
I had to do Wilfred Owen and his war poems, and Shakespeare and his Romeo and Jug or whatever her name was.
Romeo and Jun. Pete and Jun.
Romeo and Jun, you there.
PTO and Junliet.
PTO and Junliet, yeah.
That could be a good name for Let's Play Sims 3 one day.
I think he did Hamlet, didn't he, Shakespeare?
Shakespeare did loads. New records, yay. Tam's levelled up. Tam has not levelled up.
Why don't you call the guy Capulet?
Tam Capulet. Right, let's wait for the reviews, because we need to get this game out, because we are heavily in debt.
Oh, dear. We've only got that.
Come on. It's looking good. This is looking good.
Star Games. Well done.
7. Cool, this is looking good. Can we get a 10?
Oh, come on.
10.
No. Screw you, old game.
Right, let's get this on the market. This should do well. Hey, look at that.
Is that good?
That is good. Oh. That got us 62k. That has solved our debt crisis.
Oh, you're 66. Well, we had 666k there briefly. 66.6.
The bad luck one. So we could do some more research. So we can research a new topic. We could do sports or
martial arts or air.
We could do a flight simulator.
Yeah, alright, let's do
flight simulator. Alright, we'll do flight simulator.
Look at him typing away.
So, yeah. Oh, God. If only we'd got all 10s, then that would have been brilliant. We've nearly got enough to buy a license for the TES.
We're still sending those.
Ranked 26 at the moment. Successfully researched a new topic. Okay, good.
Rank 28.
I'm going to generate a game report. Just to see. Oh, somebody's coming on Skype. Hopefully you can't see that.
Went offline.
Oh, yeah, offline. Okay, that's... So, hang on a minute. Let's generate a report. You could generate reports to help gain a bit more research points.
Named hundreds.
So, you can write reports about certain games. I'm not actually sure of their purpose.
Oh, look how much money we got.
I think you can... Okay, this is... Okay, so... zombies and action is a great combination. Graphics seems to be very important for this type of game. Platform, genre, match... Okay, that's pretty good then. So you can generate reports to see what goes well with games. So, okay, let's make... Should we make Flight Simulator or Plane Simulator? Plane Sim.
Stewardess
Simulator. Pilot Sim.
Steward Simulator.
Steward Sim... Steward.
Steward or Stewardess.
I don't know how to spell it.
S-T-E-W.
We'll go Pilot because... Or no, actually Plane. Plane Simulator.
Plane.
Genre. Which one? Action? No, probably better go for simulation.
Action plane.
Yeah. Let's do this for the G64, and we'll use the Cinity engine again. So, version 2 graphics again. We've got money to spend this time, so...
We're also going to get some fish and chips.
Engine. Right, Flight Simulator doesn't really have a lot of stories and quests.
To get the passengers to the airport.
Yeah, you can just make them up yourself, though, can't you? So... Stories and quests. We don't really need that so much, but yeah.
Is there a simulator where you can sit in the airport control tower anywhere?
I guess there is.
That'd be pretty cool.
Air traffic control simulator. I guess there would be.
Actually, might.
I mean, if only there were sliders like this that we could use at college to show how much effort we put into each bit of work.
I think I roughly know.
AI doesn't really need to be that high. Level design does, because...
Yeah, but to be honest, the bar on the left's me, and the bar in the middle's you, to be
honest. Oh, no, I mean, like, for different juggling out different assignments. Right, science. So, let's say graphics on the left, then HCI, then research.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Ooh.
World design, that's got to be good. Graphic, actually, all of these have got to be good.
There we go.
And I've had an email come through on my phone. I'm just going to check that.
Oh, you will. Ooh, lovely.
Let's see what it is.
Okay,
it's Oxford Tube again.
Oh.
I had like 7 of those emails sending the survey link.
Why do you Oxford Tube email?
Because I use the buses in the morning, don't we, to get to college.
Okay,
I think it's because I've used the Wi-Fi that I keep getting the emails. I think their system's a bit messed up. Stagecoach, if you're watching this, you keep sending... I think I've had about 7 Oxford Tube
Dave
surveys
watching,
now.
Please.
Dave. Yeah. Dave, the bus driver, who drives the X30. You're a legend. You should have nominated him for Driver of the Year Award or Bus Driver Award.
He deserves it just because of his dialogue.
Because of his... what he says when you get on.
New record.
Yay, new record for technology. Come on, has Tam levelled up? Has Tam levelled up? No, he's not quite levelled up. Poor Tam. Sat there making games and he's not benefiting on his behalf, apart from earning a bit of cash.